H.C. Verma, Chapter 3, Question Number 25. A ball is thrown vertically upward with a speed of 28 meter per second. A. Find the maximum height reached by the ball. B. Find its velocity 1 second before it reaches the maximum height. C. Does the answer to part B change if initial speed is more than 28 meter per second, such as 40 meter per second or 80 meter per second? Let us take the upward direction as positive direction. The initial speed is 28 meters per second. We know that at its highest point, the ball momentarily stops, so the final speed of the ball is zero. Since the acceleration due to gravity is in downward direction, acceleration is minus 9.8 meter per second square. From third equation of Newton's equations of motion, we have v square is equal to u square plus 2as. Putting the values, we get 0 is equal to 784 minus 2 into 9.8 into s. Simplifying, we get s is equal to 784 divided by 19.6 or 40 meters. This is answer to part A of the question. As can be seen in the animation, the motion of the ball is symmetric about the time when it is at its highest position. What this means is the upward motion of the ball is identical to its downward motion. The magnitude of velocity of ball is same at any point during upward and downward motion, only the direction changes. Also, the time taken by the ball to reach the highest point from any given point is same as the time taken by the ball to reach that point from the highest position. Thus, the speed of the ball 1 second before reaching the maximum height must be same as its speed 1 second after it passes through the highest point. In that case, the initial speed is 0, acceleration due to gravity is 9.8 meter per second square, and the time taken is 1 second. Note that we have taken downward direction as positive in this case. From Newton's equation of motion, we have v is equal to u plus at. Putting the values, we get v is equal to 0 plus 9.8 into 1 or 9.8 meters per second. Thus, the velocity of ball is 9.8 meter per second in upward direction 1 second before reaching the highest position. As we have already discussed, the speed of the ball 1 second before reaching the highest position is same as its speed 1 second after it passes through the highest point. At the highest point, the speed of the ball is 0. So the speed of the ball 1 second after reaching the highest point is independent of its initial speed. Therefore, the speed of the ball 1 second before reaching the highest point is also independent of its initial speed. Therefore, the speed of the ball 1 second before reaching its highest position will not change if the initial speed of the ball is changed. This is our answer. In order to request solution to any question from H.C. Verma book, post the question number and chapter number in comments below. Like and share the video to help other students find us. Subscribe the channel, like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter for latest updates. Thank you for watching.